Welcome to the USA Eastern Territories Worship Together online service. Today, love is in the air as we celebrate Valentine's Day. 160 years ago, the chocolatier Richard Cadbury began to manufacture chocolate cupids and rosebuds placed in heart-shaped boxes, which were saved and cherished as mementos in which love letters could be stored. However, the real story of Valentine's Day began 1,751 years ago today in the Roman Empire. The emperor, Claudius Gothicus, did not have any love for Christians. On that day, at least two individuals by the name Valentine were executed for their faith. Their love for God and for people was so evident that it threatened to transform the entire Roman Empire. These saints demonstrated an act of love that so impacted those around them that their day of martyrdom continues to be celebrated as a permanent symbol of love. In the biblical love letter of 1 John chapter 4, we are reminded that love is something more than just chocolates and flowers. It's more than just a day to be celebrated once a year. We are called to have love perfected in us, to live in a permanent state of love. John says, God is love. When we take up permanent residence in a life of love, we live in God and God lives in us. If anyone boasts, I love God, and goes right on hating his brother and sister, thinking nothing of it, he's a liar. If he won't love the person he can see, how can he love the God he can't see? The command we have from Christ is blunt. Loving God includes loving people. You've got to love both. So while today we might be sharing chocolates in hearts or writing love letters in Hallmark cards, John challenges us to dig deep into the ultimate source of love and to allow it to not only transform us personally, but to overflow into every relationship, even to those who think and act differently to us. John Wesley has said, we need not think alike to love alike. So let us, during this time of worship, open our hearts to discover afresh what God has to teach us this day. Join with me in prayer. Lord of love, we declare today that you are our source of holy love. Our hearts unfold like flowers before you in adoration. We invite you to fill us with your love so that it overflows in all that we say, all that we do, and all that we are. In a world that is filled with fear, may love overflow from us to bring courage. In a world that is filled with anger, may love overflow from us to bring calm. In a world that is filled with unbelief, may love overflow from us to inspire faith. In a world that is filled with despair, may love overflow from us to bring hope. In a world that has forgotten to love, may love overflow from us to see your kingdom come and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We invite you this day to be the Lord of love in our hearts. Loving Father, Christ our brother, let your light upon us shine. Teach us how to love each other. Lift us to the joy divine. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning. Please join with me as we read God's word together from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 1 to 3. If I could speak all the languages of earth and of angels, but didn't love others, I would only be a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I had the gift of prophecy, and if I understood all of God's secret plans and possessed all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains but didn't love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I have to the poor and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it, but if I didn't love others, I would have gained nothing. This is the word of the Lord. May it fill our minds, saturate our hearts, and spill over into our lives.
Your love is devoted, like a ring of solid gold, like a vow that is tested, like a covenant of old. Your love is enduring through the winter rain and beyond the horizon, with mercy for today. Faithful you have been, faithful you will be. Can you pledge yourself to me? And that's why I sing your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. You father the orphan, your kindness makes us whole. Your shoulder weakness, your strength becomes our own. You're making me like you, clothing me in white, bringing beauty for ashes. For you have your bride, free from all her guilt, rid of all her shame, known by her true name. And that's why I sing.
It's so good to be with all of you this morning.
It really is. I'm glad to be with you, too.
Oh, thanks. She's so funny.
Well, it's Valentine's Day.
Yes, it is.
Happy Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day.
And I guess love is in the air.
Oh, goodness. And speaking of love, I hope all of you at home know and feel the genuine love that is shared each week through this territorial broadcast. It's an expression of love for God and a love for all of you.
Love is the greatest.
Amen.
At the end of 1 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 13, we have these words. Three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love.
Amen. God's love has been given to us so that we can share it with others. And that's what makes us all who we are, because it comes to God's love flowing through us.
You know, there's something Jesus said that we want to think about today. Jesus said to those who followed him, "Your love for one another will prove to the world that you are my disciples." Mm. Isn't that a beautiful thought?
It really is.
That really should be our ultimate goal,
right?
To love in such a way that it points people to Jesus.
The Bible also says in 1 John 4:7-10, "Dear friends, let us continue to love one another, for love comes from God. Anyone who loves God is a child of God and knows God. But anyone who does not love does not know God, for God is love. God showed how much he loved us by sending his one and only Son into the world so that we might have eternal life through him. This is real love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as a sacrifice to take away our sins.
You know, we're not called to be followers of Christ just to be happy and content. We're called to be vessels and channels of God's love. First of all, to experience his love firsthand in our own lives, and then to pass that on to others. Mm.
Jesus said it clearly. So now I am giving you a new commandment. Mm. Love each other just as I have loved you. You should love each other. Your love for one another will prove to the world that you are my disciples.
You know, when Jesus was asked, what is the greatest commandment in the Bible? He didn't answer with just one commandment, but he gave two. Jesus replied, you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. This is the first and the greatest commandment. A second is equally important. Love your neighbor as yourself. And that entire law and all those demands of the prophets are based on these two commandments.
Right. Our greatest examples of love come from Jesus himself. Jesus formed relationships with others to show them how much God the Father loved them.
One of Jesus' most powerful teaching moments to his disciples of serving people throughout loving relationships was in that upper room. He bent down and he washed their feet. Mm. You know how the story goes.
Right.
The time of his crucifixion was near, and Jesus wanted to give his disciples an example of love that they can follow. So Jesus took the position and task of a servant, and he washed his disciples' feet. The Bible says in John chapter 13, verses 12 through 15, after washing their feet, he put on his robe again and sat down, and he asked, do you understand what I was doing? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right because that's what I am. And since I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash each other's feet. I've given you an example to follow. Do as I've done to you. And then Jesus brought his teaching moment to a close with these final words. So now I am giving you a new commandment. Amen. Love each other just as I have loved you. You should love each other.
Amen.
And your love for one another will prove to the world that you are my disciples.
Amen. Just as I have loved you, you are also to love one another. Once we grasp the love Jesus showed us, we must turn around and offer that same kind of love to others. But let's face it, it's not always easy to love people, but it is essential.
There's great power in love.
Right.
It's transforming.
It is.
Love is the answer to so many of life's problems.
Right. One of the most familiar passages of Scripture is 1 Corinthians 13, where Paul describes what love really is. But before Paul gets to the qualities of love, he introduces the subject by emphasizing that love must be the motive and reason for the right things that we do. Paul wrote, if I could speak all of the languages of the earth and of angels, but I didn't love others, I would only be a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I had the gift of prophecy, and if I understood all of God's secret plans and possessed all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains, but I didn't love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I have to the poor and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it. But if I didn't love others, I would have gained nothing.
The list that Paul gave here is quite impressive. The point of this passage can be stated in one sentence. Mm. Whatever we do or whatever we say, it's all useless without love.
Amen. God is saying that we can pile up all the good deeds in the world, all the education, all the spiritual gifts, and all the noble works that we like. But without love, they mean nothing.
Paul goes on to share what this love looks like. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way.
Mm-hmm.
It is not irritable. It keeps no record of being wronged. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out.
Right.
Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance. Mm.
I know we still have a long way to go in this area.
Yes, we do.
Having God's love always flowing through us isn't always the easiest thing.
No, I think it's true for many who are listening to us today. Some of you who have joined us are struggling with some very difficult people in your lives. Some of you may be dealing with some really painful circumstances in your own life right now.
And in these moments, when we've been deeply hurt, the temptation is to respond with anger and bitterness, and it overwhelms us to the point that we often sink to the level of those who have attacked us.
But Paul reminds us that there is a better way.
Right.
God calls us to love, and it means responding in kindness when we've been repeatedly mistreated. It means finding a way to reach out and bring healing to relationships that seem hopeless. But this kind of love is not easy for us.
Not at all. But love isn't about us, is it?
No.
It's about God. God is love. And true love starts with Him and comes down to us and flows through us. It's only because of His love given to us that we can extend love to each other.
Paul said it this way in Ephesians chapter 5, verses 1 through 2. Imitate God, therefore, in everything you do, because you are His dear children. Live a life filled with love, following the example of Christ. He loved us and offered Himself as a sacrifice for us, a pleasing aroma to God.
Amen. It's a very high calling to imitate God and to walk in love as Christ loved us. Jesus gave us the best example of loving people when He was here on the earth. It's our job now to reflect the love He showed and do that for the people we encounter every day, family, friends, enemies even, people we don't even know.
That's our desire for all of us, that His love would flow through us right here today.
Right.
In all that we face or all that we are struggling through with right now, that His love would be there.
Amen. We want to end these same words of Jesus with that we shared at the beginning of our message today. Jesus said to those who followed Him, "Your love for one another will prove to the world that you are My disciples." Wouldn't we like to be known for that kind of love in our lives?
Amen. Three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love.
Amen. God's love is the greatest of these and is available to all of us who ask for it today.
Amen. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we're amazed by how much You love us. How high, how deep, how wide is Your love for us. And yet, while we were still sinners, You sent Your Son Jesus to die for us. That's true love, and Your love is reaching us right here, right now.
Amen.
And we thank You for that. We desire today for that love to flow through us. You've created us in a special way that Your love can flow through us onto others.
Amen.
And Lord, if there are any hearts within the sound of our voices this morning that are broken, we pray that Your Holy Spirit would bring restoration and healing.
Yes.
We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Stories of what they think you're
Please receive the benediction. Let's pray together. Dear Lord, thank you for your unconditional, perfect, and sacrificial love revealed to us through Jesus Christ. Help the same love to be evident in our lives, in our words, in our actions, our attitudes, and our choices, so that people will see and experience the love of Christ through us. Forgive us when anger, bitterness, resentment, comparison, and self-defense have prevented us from showing this kind of love to others. Fill us with your love today so we can love like Jesus. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for joining us on this special Valentine's Day Worship Together service. As you leave, remember the words of William Booth, who challenges us: love is the standard by which God measures the value of your service on earth and by which he will measure your reward in heaven. May each one of us live out this love just where God has placed us. If God has been speaking to you today and you have any special prayer requests, please reach out to our Spiritual Life Development Department. Their information will follow this video. Next week, we will begin our Worship Together Lent series entitled Windows on Easter. Join us next week as Colonel Ray Jackson explores the Good Samaritan as we focus on the window of love. Thank you, and God bless you this Valentine's Day.